Welcome to private-person.com. This information is being made available in order to assist people to understand and learn how to live a private life within our society, a society that has more or less taken over our private rights and we don't know why. So this is a brief introduction to some of the main concepts that are going to be further explored within the website once you go on and want to learn more. So with regards to a private person, it is a term that many people are unfamiliar with. Most people are more familiar with the term natural person. There is a difference and a distinction, which we'll address later. But the first basic thing with regards to our legal system is that there are, in fact, two legal systems in operation in the world, and specifically in common law countries. Canada is a common law country, which also has a civil law jurisdiction. And it's not just civil law, it is Roman municipal civil law, and we'll refer to it as Roman civil law for ease of reference. The United States is also a common law country with a Roman civil law state within it, Louisiana, and the Roman civil law has effectively overtaken the common law. It has not eliminated it, it has not destroyed it. The common law is still there, it still works, the judges still recognize the common law, but there's some very specific reasons why most people trying to claim common law never get access to it. So we'll just take a look at some of the ideas here with regards to common law. All of your power and freedom reside and are protected within the common law. You have full responsibility and full liability within common law. You have your privacy rights and your property rights. And public servants are actually your servants. They are your employees. The government is a creation of the people, and the government hires people in order to serve the people, and those are your public servants, hence the name serving the public, public servants. We'll talk about why that has switched around in a moment. It is the private side. This is where privacy rights and property rights exist, and they don't exist anywhere else. It is the government has no business in your private affairs, your private business. This is where all private stuff is what you're looking to live with regards to your life is staying on the private side. And contract law is what rules on the common law side. A contract is deemed or considered to be the law between the parties. And so the contract sets the law. The agreement between individuals sets the law. So ensuring that you stay in the common law and your contracts that you enter become the law and they cannot be infringed upon or interfered with by the state. That is the basic concept behind the common law, is leaving the individual alone and protecting their rights through the system. And what has happened is those have gone away because Roman civil law has effectively taken over, and it's not because they've necessarily done something as much as we have abandoned the civil law, or the common law. So in Roman civil law, the government creates the rules and regulations. They become the master, and we do what we're allowed to do and given permission to do. You have to go and do as you're told. You have to seek permission for permits and licenses. The definition of a license is permission to do something that would otherwise be illegal without the license. So in Roman civil law, things are made illegal by rule of the government. And then you have to go ask permission. There's very little freedom involved in that system. You have limited rights, only the rights that the government acknowledges they will allow you to have. Whereas in common law, you have unlimited right with only two rules. Do no harm at property or an individual, or do no threat of harm to property or an individual. So those are the only two guiding principles in common law, whereas in Roman civil law, you don't have the right to do anything without permission. The public servants effectively become your masters, because in Roman civil law, you have stepped out of common law and you now are representing some type of artificial person, a fictional entity of some type, and the public servants are the ones who enforce the rules against the public entities, the artificial persons. So they effectively become the regulators of the rules against the people who have stepped into Roman civil law. It is the public side. All the information is available to the public. There is no privacy. and it is with regards to protecting the public. All actions are done in the interests of the public. Individual rights don't really exist. And therefore, public policy rules. It's not about your rights and the law and the contracts. It's, is this important for the purposes of public policy? And here's a definition of Roman civil law from Bouvier's. The municipal code of the Romans is so-called. It is a rule of action adopted by mankind in a state. And that is what we are effectively operating under, is the municipal code from the Romans in our civil law systems. And the civil law has effectively, again, kind of buried the common law, but the common law, again, is still there, ready and willing to be accessed by anybody who chooses to. So both systems work, but very few people access the common law. They're stuck in the Roman law system, Roman civil law system, and don't know why it doesn't seem right, and so on. The privateperson.com website is about helping people understand there is the Roman civil law system, how they're in it, how to get out of it, and how to live their life privately in common law. Now, they will try to prevent you from accessing common law. Whoever they are, it's not the point. But the common law is recognized throughout statute law, throughout case law decisions, in many, many places. So there's no real, it's not really hidden if you go looking for it, but you're not educated about it. And the statutes are written in such a confusing way that people just don't understand it. They've basically given up trying to figure out the legal system because it's become so complex. And it's been made complex to hide the fact that you have these rights and you have this freedom, but they've been, you know, hiding it from you. And if you go in and try and claim it, they will try and dissuade you from claiming it and do a number of things to get you off the track of trying to claim it and step back into the Roman civil law system. It's very important that you know how each the Roman civil law and the common law affect your life. There are instances that are possible as examples of how things change when you choose to be in one or the other, or the effects of not knowing and how you effectively are treated in each one without really understanding why. And you need to know how to live successfully in both. Because the world exists in both of those systems, it's important to know the basics of each so that you can step in and step out of each one depending on the circumstances and the particular needs of the time and how those systems are used to control or free you. So that's one of the ideas behind the privateperson.com website, is to assist with that. Now, one of the key concepts with regards to the entire game of law is that law as a whole is fiction. It's all a set of rules made up by men in order to try and play this game of life and society under some agreements. There is one group of people who are interested in individual rights, and there's another group of people interested in controlling others and believing that it's all about the greater good for the greater number, and it's not about the individual rights. Those are two different philosophical positions that are demonstrated by the Roman civil law system and by the common law system. In either system, you have something that is called status, and status is where you get recognized by the law. If you do not have status in a legal system, you don't get recognized by the courts. You don't get recognized with rights and property rights and privacy rights and so on. So in order to achieve status, you go from being a man or a sovereign, which is beholden to no one, not following the rules of society, which is possible to do, but it's very challenging based on everybody's understanding of the system right now. And you give up some of your sovereignty by agreeing to be a part of society and agreeing to be play by some of the rules, and also therefore get the protections of society. You do that by stepping into the system and being recognized in common law only as a private person. Now, a lot of people are concerned about the term person as a term which creates an artificial connection and a control of the system, and that's true in many cases, but the modifying word is private, and private only exists in the common law world, and so you're taking and modifying the word person with the word private and ensuring what type of person it is, and it is a person with common law status in a common law system with the highest degree of rights recognized by a legal system. Now, many people have heard of the term natural person, And lots of court decisions and judges ignore it, say it's not valid, and various other things. Now, the interesting thing with regards to research, and there's more information on all of these things I'm talking about within the website, is that there is a difference between a private person and a natural person. Because of the two different jurisdictions, Roman civil law and common law, it's referred to as bijural, two environments, two juristic persons. And in Canada, there is on the Department of Justice, Federal Department of Justice website, a bijural terminology information section. And what the federal government did through this system is go through the federal statutes, because Canada is a bijural jurisdiction. It has common law in the majority of the country and Roman civil law in the province of Quebec. And with the federal laws applying all across the country to all provinces, they went through the federal laws and said, well, we've been using common law terms, but since many of these laws apply to Quebec, we have to find a word that works in Quebec as well. And the word they came up with in this particular case was changing from private person to natural person. Natural person exists in duality in the civil law system and in the common law system. So natural person really comes down to which one, the common law person or the civil law person. There is an opportunity of a gray area of, how do I tell which one it is? Whereas private person only and solely exists in common law with its privacy and property rights intact, because of the modifying term of private, which does not exist in civil law. Privacy rights don't exist in civil law. So you can't have a private person in civil law. The reference that they're using in civil law is natural person. And because the world is bijural, even the international courts have adopted the term natural person, because they have to deal with both jurisdictions. So if you want to ensure that you're recognized in common law and are claiming the right status in common law, because common law does offer protections, you want to claim the term or the phrase private person. And that, again, is immediate recognition of the correct status in common law. The next question becomes, are you of full capacity or limited capacity? Many people step into court and get challenged when they claim private person or natural person, and that's naturally what they're going to do. They don't want somebody just to come in with a magic phrase and use it to get out of something. Now, the definition or idea of full capacity or limited capacity is that when you achieve legal age, you're deemed to be of full capacity. And legal age varies from jurisdiction to jurisdiction. So let's just talk about the idea of legal age. What happens at legal age? Well, before legal age, you have limited capacity. Your parents are responsible and liable for your actions. They are the ones who have to answer to the legal system if you do damage or threat of damage or to a person or property. After the age of legal age, you have a deeming by the legal system that you are of full capacity now. And you must demonstrate that full capacity. And how do you demonstrate it? You demonstrate it by showing you have full knowledge. You've all grown up now, and you know what the difference is between right and wrong, and you can choose. And the choices that you make, you're willing to be fully responsible for. And you're also willing to be fully liable for. Which means that you know when you do something right or wrong, you knew it was wrong when you did it, and you accept responsibility. Yes, it was me. I did that thing. I know it was wrong, but I did it anyways. And I'm willing to pay for my damages that I've created by this. These three steps are how you demonstrate that you are of full capacity and not of limited capacity. If you demonstrate that you are of limited capacity and you're over legal age, I believe that the court system then takes over in the Roman civil law process called parens patriae, where they take a guardianship of you in order to protect yourself from harm to yourself and protect society from harm from you going out there, because you've demonstrated to them that you don't understand the difference between right and wrong, and you're not willing to take responsibility or liability for your actions. So what you do in court and what you do in your processes of handling things is you must demonstrate these three things in order to be recognized by the courts that you are of full capacity. And you will be tested. If you walk into court and you say, I'm a private person of full capacity, they're going to challenge you. They're going to ask you questions. And find out how you respond to see if you really do understand what that means and that you're going to be demonstrating responsibility and liability with your actions. You're not using it as a way to escape them. Now, a private person of full capacity has unlimited capacities. All right, this is the status. When you step into a legal system, you start out with a status, and then the status derives into different types of capacities. In the unlimited capacities of a private person, you can become a driver, taxpayer, employee, officer, registered voter, and many, many, many more. Now, do you become these things? No, you become the representative in some legal way of these things. You are never the driver, never the taxpayer, never the employee, but you become responsible for acting on the behalf of one of those legal persons. So there's more information again on the site and all these ideas. So one of the ways that the system defines and separates out the different statuses of people is through capitis dominio. And again, many people have heard from courts and court decisions that capitis dominio means nothing. And judges say it doesn't mean nothing, so obviously they're right. Well, guess what? The Roman civil law, if it's part of the system, if it is actually what's operating, capitis dominio is one of the Roman civil law principles. And this is how they determine what status somebody is coming to them on a piece of paper. So they know the statuses before the people come to court, and with all their legal processes, who are they dealing with? So capitis dominio is in three forms. It's capitis dominio minima, media, and maxima. And those are demonstrated by capitalization of the first letter of the name. It takes you from the sovereign man outside the legal system with no protections and no rights within the system. You give up some of your freedom in order to participate in society. You capitalize your name, so you give up some of your freedom for the benefits and protections of society. So it's a loss of status, but it's a minimal loss of status. Media is where the last name is capital, full capitalization. And this is not spelling. Many people refer to this as spelling. It is not spelling. Let me repeat this. It is not spelling. It's the same letters. It is a difference in style. This is the correct term, and if you go in talking about spelling, you're demonstrating lack of knowledge. They can also play tricks on you because, no, they're not going to change the spelling because it doesn't matter. Well, it's not about spelling. It's about the style. So correct that one if you've been using spelling. And the maxima is the full name fully capitalized, styled in all capitals. Now, this is the maximum loss of status where you actually lose your freedom. And this is where you lose many rights but not your freedom. And you can go into Black's Law Dictionary and you can find capitis dominio and look these things up. They do not give you the defined styles associated with it, but this is what the system operates on. Now, the other distinction is a natural person or artificial. Well, there's a private person who represents an artificial person potentially. You don't become an artificial person. There are also corporations where you go to the state and you apply for a corporation and they create an artificial person for you, which you then are the director and CEO or whatever. Partnerships are artificial persons. It's creating through contract another entity that has a liability and responsibility of its own. Trusts, I believe, are another form of artificial person. And there are many others, but this is just some of the basics that are used on a daily basis. Now, a natural person is what's generally defined in law dictionaries now, but if you do your research and if you follow some of the teaching within the private-person.com website, you will find the distinction between private person and natural person. For the purposes of clarity, I prefer and choose private person, but natural person will work if you demonstrate all of the capacities associated with private person. If you want to use natural person, I'd recommend using natural person in private capacity as a distinguishing factor so that you're not deemed to be a natural person who is in the civil law system of limited capacity. So that's just a quick overview of some of the key concepts within the privateperson.com website, and that's private-person.com. Enter on in if you want to get more information on all of these things.